Welcome back to another episode of History Bodied. In this video, we will be talking about Lithuania and its history and culture. Let's begin with today's video. Lithuania, a country of northeastern Europe, is the southernmost and largest of the three Baltic states. Lithuania was a powerful empire that dominated much of Eastern Europe in the 14th-16th centuries before becoming part of the Polish-Lithuanian Confederation for the next two centuries. Aside from a brief period of independence from 1918 to 1940, Lithuania was occupied by Russia beginning in 1795, was controlled by Germany for a brief period during World War II, and was incorporated into the in 1944 as one of its constituent republics. On March 11, 1990, Lithuania declared its independence by a unanimous vote of its newly elected parliament. The new Soviet parliament acknowledged Lithuania's independence on September 6, 1991. Lithuania was admitted into the European Union, EU, and the North Atlantic Treaty Organization in 2004. The capital is Vilnius. Lithuania is bounded by Latvia to the north, Belarus to the east and south, Poland and the detached Russian oblast of Kaliningrad to the southwest, and the Baltic Sea to the west. Ethnic Lithuanians make up more than four-fifths of the country's population. There are also Russians and Poles and lesser numbers of Belarusians, Ukrainians, Latvians, Tatars, Roma, Gypsies, and others. There was a significant Jewish community in Lithuania before World War II, and an influx of Jews from German-controlled Poland in 1941 boosted this population to nearly 250,000. By 1944, however, the majority of the population had been murdered, deported, or sent to concentration camps during the Holocaust. The official language of Lithuania is Lithuanian. Russian, Polish, Belarusian, Ukrainian, and other languages are spoken in the larger cities. Yiddish is commonly spoken by members of the tiny remaining Jewish community in Lithuania. Lithuania was the last pagan country in Europe, accepting Roman Catholicism in the late 14th century. About four-fifths of the population is Roman Catholic. There are smaller groups of evangelical Lutherans and other Protestants, as well as people of other faiths. Elements of the pagan religion have survived in the countryside. There has been a modest but steady movement of people to the city since the 1990s, encouraged by the planning of regional centers, such as Alytus, Marijampol, Utena, Plunge, and Mažeikiai. By the early 21st century, about two-thirds of the total population lived in urban areas. Even before independence from the USSR was formally established, the Lithuanian government had embarked on a program of dismantling the Soviet economic system. Beginning in February 1991, laws were passed to facilitate privatization. Complications marred the government's aspirations, however. Foremost, the bulk of Lithuania's trade was still closely linked to the former republics of the USSR, which were themselves in the throes of economic collapse. Second, Lithuania was dependent on critically important foreign oil and natural gas and industrial raw materials. Finally, the transition to a market economy had caused high rates of inflation and unemployment. Nevertheless, the succeeding governments continued to implement stringent stabilization policies. By 1995, inflation had been reduced, and the country's trade balance was positive for the first time since independence. Lithuania was admitted to the EU in 2004. Lithuania's current constitution was approved by a national referendum in 1992. The Republic of Lithuania, formerly the Lithuanian Soviet Socialist Republic, is administered by a president and a legislature, the Seimas, under a parliamentary system. The Seimas consists of 141 members, who are elected to four-year terms. The prime minister, formally appointed by the president, oversees the country's day-to-day affairs and is generally the leader of the Seimas' majority party. The president is popularly elected for a five-year term, with a maximum of two consecutive terms. Lithuania is divided into apskritis, counties, which are then divided into rajonas, districts. The districts are further divided into savivalbaid, regional towns, urban settlements, and localities. The governor of each county is appointed by the national government. The districts are self-governing and elect local councils, which in turn elect the mayors. In Lithuania, there is a high level of interest in various aspects of cultural life. Despite modern influences, Lithuanian folklore continues to be a significant part of national heritage. Lithuanian songs and a remarkable collection of fairy tales, legends, proverbs, and aphorisms have roots deep in a language and culture that are among the oldest in Europe. In the 20th century, however, war and Soviet occupation stifled the works of many Lithuanian artists, writers, poets, and playwrights. As a predominantly Roman Catholic country, Lithuania celebrates all the major Christian holidays. The traditional Christmas Eve feast consists of 12 vegetarian dishes served on a straw-covered table, meat being saved for Christmas Day. Cabbages and potatoes form a considerable part of the Lithuanian diet, as do dairy products. Traditional dishes include cepelinai, a large, zeppelin-shaped, stuffed potato dumpling, cabbage rolls, cold beet soup, and potato pancakes. Well, that brings us to the end of today's video all about Lithuania and its history. Have any of you guys ever been to Lithuania? Maybe we have some Lithuanian subscribers who know some interesting facts we didn't include? Let us know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed today's episode and found it interesting, make sure to leave us a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to History Body, so you never miss out on taking a trip back in time with us to the most fascinating moments in human history. Thanks for watching. See you again soon in another video.